Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to quickly get started with Azure Synapse Analytics. Stay tuned. Boom, 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 boom. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. I've been taking the journey of Azure Synapse Analytics, and Adam made me realize, he was like, hey, you didn't show people how to get started. Well, I created a Synapse workspace, and then I just started doing stuff in Azure Synapse Studio. He was like, well, maybe you should show people. I was like, oh. Yeah, it's a great idea. So you guys know what I like to do? Instead of all this talking, let's head over to my laptop. So the first thing, you need an Azure subscription and you'll need a resource group that you're owner of. Once you have those things, head over to your Azure portal. You can go here and search for Azure Synapse Analytics, or if the icon appears in the list of Azure services at the top, just hover over it and choose the Create button. It's gonna bring you to the Create Synapse Workspace experience. Find the subscription that the resource group lives in, and then you wanna find the resource group. Manage resource group is optional, so we're not going to fill that out. Workspace name is required. So everywhere you see a little red asterisk, that's the stuff we're going to fill out. So we're going to call this one Patrick Synapse, and it'll do a validation to make sure there's no other workspace out there. And then we're going to skip this, and then we need to create a data lake storage Gen 2. We're going to store lots of stuff there. We're going to use one that I created earlier. Here we go. And then it'll automatically populate the file system name that I created, or you can create brand new ones. Doesn't matter. Then we're going to go to security. For people that use SQL Server back in the day like me, they always allow you two types of authentication, just Windows, but now it's Azure Active Directory and SQL authentication. So we're going to go ahead and put a password so we can authenticate both ways if we want to. And I love how it validates that I'm providing a secure password. It's all we need to fill out on this screen. Networking, we're not going to put it in a virtual network. It's going to let it handle all the connections from IP addresses for now. We'll secure it up later. We're not going to add any tags, review and create. And guess what? It's going to go through a validation process. We're going to click create. In a few short minutes, that resource will be available. Then the magic begins. Let me show you. Once it's available, you'll land on a page that looks like this. Now you want to go to Synapse Studio. And I love how they have this get started icon right here. And there's a lot of documentation for you to read, but I'm just going to click here to open up Azure Synapse Studio. Once it launches, I'll take a quick tour and I'm going to show you how you can use a wizard to generate our first query. In some subsequent videos, I'll show you how to write some T-SQL queries. So here in Azure Synapse Studio, there's so many things you can do right out the gate. So I can ingest some data, I can explore and analyze, I can even visualize data directly with Power BI. And then you'll see all these different hubs. There's my data hub, where you can see here's my lake databases that I've already created. If I click on linked, you'll see this is the data lake storage that I attached when I was creating it. We're gonna come back to this one, so let me show you something here. You can see where I can develop notebooks, data flows. Data flows is where I can do all my data ingestion, create some pipelines and do some data mappings for some transformations of my data. I can integrate. You can see I've been playing with pipelines. I can monitor everything. You can see here's my SQL pools, where there's my built-in serverless one. I don't have to do anything. Once I provision this, I automatically have a serverless pool. And if I upload some files, I can start querying those files. I'm going to show you that. Stay tuned. And then I have my Apache Spark pools, my Data Explorer pools. But then I can look at all the activities that are happening here. And so you can see that I've run some queries here. I haven't run any KQL queries. I can monitor just about anything. And then here, this is where I manage everything. So I can create dedicated SQL pools. I already have the built-in serverless one. I can create Apache Spark pools. I can link to external services. There's so many things I can do built directly into this studio. My favorite thing is that most of the things that you're going to do here just require you to learn the clicks. Imagine you have a Parquet file or a CSV file and you just want to check out the data in it. You don't want to open it up. You're used to writing queries. How would you do that? Using Azure Synapse Studio, if I go over here to the data hub, expand this out, and this is the data lake that I connected to when I was setting this up. If I go to the file system, you'll notice right here, it says upload. And I can upload directly from my local machine. So you see I have a small Parquet file here. Say upload it. Just takes a few seconds to get it uploaded. So I'm gonna right click on it, new SQL script, select top 1000 rows. It wrote it for me. I can run this. And this is very similar to T-SQL. I just use an open row set to go against that file system. If I wanted to count the rows in it, if I wanted to do some groupings or anything like that, IntelliSense is built in. And I can run a query and see there's 100,000 rows in that Parquet file. What? This is so simple, so easy. It's all about learning the clicks. So I'm gonna pass this back to you guys. Have you started your journey with Azure Synapse Analytics? I'd love to know what roadblocks or what neat things have you found just in your getting started path. You know what to do. Let's continue the conversation where? in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.